हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिड लर्न अबाउट द थर्मल रेजिस्टेंस कंसेप्ट एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल एनालॉजी. ओके, इन विच वी हैव लर्न दैट व्हाट इज थर्मल रेजिस्टेंस, द डिटेल्स ऑफ थर्मल रेजिस्टेंस एंड हाउ द इलेक्ट्रिकल सिस्टम द ओम्स लॉ के इज एनालॉगस टू थर्मल सिस्टम्स. ओके, सो इन केस यू हैव नॉट चेकड आउट दैट लेक्चर देन यू मस्ट सी दैट फर्स्ट. ओवर हेयर इज द लिंक. ओके, ओवर हेयर इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल टॉक अबाउट इन केस देर इज थर्मल रेजिस्टेंस नेटवर्क मीन्स नंबर ऑफ थर्मल कंडक्टर्स विच आर इन्वॉल्व इन द नेटवर्क देन हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द हीट ट्रांसफर रेट. सो डायरेक्टली कमिंग टू द टॉपिक दैट यू कैन सी ओवर हेयर दैट देर इज अ वॉल एंड यू कैन सी ओवर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड देर इज अ पिंक कलर्ड प्लास्टर. ओके, इट इज मेड अप ऑफ सॉलिड मटेरियल एंड सपोज द थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी इज K1. ओके, एंड द लेंथ ऑफ दिस प्लास्टर इज L1 एंड देन देर इज अ ब्रिक वर्क. ओके, हुज थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी इज K2 एंड देन देर इज प्लास्टर whose thermal conductivity is K3 and the this thing, the thickness is L3. Now in case I am applying the temperature differences, left plaster face T1 and right plaster face T2, okay, and I want to find out the heat transfer rate. So how to find out that? We know this thing that in case there is a unique conductor, okay, you can see unique conductor made up of some unique material, length of this conductor is L and cross sectional area is A, thermal conductivity is K and we are applying temperature differences. Okay, in that case, according to Fourier's law, the heat transfer rate is Q equals to KA T1 minus T2 upon L. But it is a unique conductor. Over here, what we see that there are three types of conductor which are connected in a combination, in a particular combination, particular arrangement. So in this case, how to find out the heat transfer rate? Okay, so for such cases, thermal resistance concept is helpful to find the heat transfer rate. Okay. So before proceeding, we must recall the Ohm's law, okay, the electrical resistance system, electrical resistance network system. What we see over here that there are electrical resistances R1, R2 and like this Rn, all are in series. Okay, just we are refreshing the concept. Okay, so in this case, if we are applying the potential, electric potential V1 over this end and V2 over the opposite end, okay, and we want to find out the electric current flowing, then we can see that these resistances are in series. This is called a series combination. And the overall resistance due to all these resistances will be R will be, this is overall resistance will be the algebraic addition of all the resistances. Okay. So in case we want to find out the electric current, simple I will be equals to the electric potential difference V1 minus V2 upon the overall electric resistance. Similarly, in case resistances are in parallel, you can see R1, R2 and Rn applied with same potential difference, all the resistances are with same potential difference. Okay, then the effective resistance due to all those resistances which are connected in parallel, 1 by R effective will be 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by Rn. The reciprocals are added, we will get the reciprocal of effective resistance. Okay, now again, what will the current flowing through this system? This formula will be used. V1 minus V2 is the electric potential difference upon R is the overall electrical resistance. Okay, so what happens that the thermal resistance concept is analogous to electrical resistance concept. Okay, so what we see over here that this wall consists of three conductors one after another. Okay, starting from temperature T1 ultimately ending with T2. Between T1 and T2 there are three conductors which are in arrangement of one after another, so these are in series. Okay, so what happens in case we have the thermal resistance of this plaster, first plaster, left hand side plaster, and thermal resistance of this brickwork and thermal resistance of this plaster 2 which is over right hand side. So all these thermal resistances are in series. So what will be the effective thermal resistance? It will be the algebraic addition of all the thermal resistances because the thermal resistance concept is analogous to electrical resistance concepts. Now how to find out the heat transfer rate? See, over here I is charge transfer rate, we will write Q heat transfer rate. Okay, it is equals to V1 minus V2 is electrical potential difference. Okay, so over here T1 minus T2 will be the thermal potential difference. Okay, electrical potential difference is the driving factor for flow of charge. Similarly, temperature difference is the driving factor for flow of heat. Okay, so we will write it over here T1 minus T2 in place of V1 minus V2, and whatever the effective thermal resistance will be, that will be in the denominator as like that of I equals to V1 minus V2 by R, Q will be T1 minus T2 by R. Okay, so first of all, what will be the thermal resistance of this left hand side plaster? For that I will recall again that what are the formulas for finding the thermal resistance of a particular conductor. See over here that if there is a thermal conductor, okay, you can see this is a conductor of uniform cross sectional area, conductivity, thermal conductivity is K and temperature difference is applied and L is the LAN. So what will happen is a solid conductor, so heat conduction will take place. So in such case, the thermal resistance will be given by R conduction will be equals to L by Ka. For conduction, this is the formula. And over here what we see that there is some surface area, hot surface, and this is cold surrounding. So suppose this is made up of air, so surrounding heat is transferring from this surface to the surrounding air, so convection will take place. So in that case, for convection, the effective resistance will be 1 by HA. H is the convective heat transfer coefficient. Okay, so in short, I told you that what are the formulas associated for finding the thermal resistance. Okay, now again coming back, this left hand side plaster, okay, so through this plaster conduction will take place. So the we will use the formula of thermal resistance due to conduction. So that will be L1, that is the length of this plaster, upon K1 into A. Suppose A is the area of this plaster. Okay, so I am writing over here that R1, R plaster 1 will be equals to L1 by K1 A. Similarly, R brick, again the length or the thickness of this brickwork is how much? This is L2, okay, and conductivity is K2. So R brick will be L2 by K2. Area is same, okay, from beginning to end the surface area is same, okay. And for this R plaster 2, plaster 2 will be equals to whatever the thickness or length of plaster upon K3A. Okay. Now, what will be the effective resistance? Simple, all these three resistances are in series. So, we know the same thermal resistance concept is analogous to electrical resistance concept. Okay. So, in case series combination is there, then the resistances are added. So, over here also the effective resistance will be R is equals to R plaster 1 plus R plaster plus R brick plus R plaster 2. Okay. Now, what will be the heat transfer rate? Okay, simple, I told you heat transfer rate is equal to T1 minus T2 upon the overall resistance. Okay, so Q is equals to T1 minus T2 by R. So, like this way we can find out that what will the heat transfer rate occurring through this wall. Okay. Now, one more example I will take. What we see over here that there are resistances which are connected in a particular combination. Okay, these are thermal resistances applied between temperatures T1 and T2. Okay. So, R1, R2, R3 are the thermal resistances over the top, and over the bottom R4 and R5 are the thermal resistances. Okay, their individual resistances are R1, R2, R3 and R4, R5. Okay. Now, what we see over here, first of all we can draw a thermal resistance network. This is the physical diagram. So, it is like this, that this is R1, okay, and R2 and R3, all these three are in series. This is R2 and this is R3. So, this is R2 and this is R3, and these two R4 and R5 are also in series in the bottom. Okay, so R4, okay, and R5, like this. So, this is our the network diagram, thermal resistance network diagram. This is R4 and this is R5. Now, what we see that over here these R2, this R1, R2 and R3, okay, all these three are in series. So, in case I am taking a RA as the effective resistance due to these three resistances, so it will be algebraic addition of R1 plus R2 and R3. Similarly, over here also what we see, this R4 and R5 are also in series, two resistances are in series. So, in case I am taking the this thing, for this combination it is RB, then RB equals to R4 plus R5. Now, what will be the overall thermal resistance? This RA and RB themselves are parallel. Okay, I have not applied the temperatures. Okay, so over here it is temperature T1, it is T2. Okay, so 1 by R overall will be equals to 1 by RA plus 1 by Rb. Okay, so after finding the R, okay, what will be the heat transfer rate? I am writing over here, that will be Q is equals to again the temperature difference applied upon overall thermal resistance. That's it. One more example I am taking. Suppose that this is a room, we can see, and it contains a window in it, okay, and inside room the temperature is T1, outside is T2, and taking T2 is greater than T1. So what will happen? Heat will start coming from outside, reaching to this window, and ultimately go inside, because heat always transfers from high temperature to low temperature. Okay. Now we have to find out that what will be the associated heat transfer rate. Okay. So first of all, I am taking this window system exclusive. Okay. Suppose this is my window, magnified view. Okay. This is the window, and means side view I am taking, and the thickness of this glass window, this is made up of glass, okay, glass window, thickness is T and thermal conductivity is K, okay. So what will happen? Outside temperature is T2 and inside temperature is T1, okay. So what will happen? First of all, from the outside air, the heat will reach to this outside surface of glass, and the mode will be what? Convection. And then there will be conduction through this thickness of glass. This heat transfer is conduction, and ultimately reaching the inner surface and to the inside of room, it will be again this convection. Okay. So what we see? First convection, then conduction, then again convection. So there will be three resistances involved, and which are in series one after another. The resistance due to convection from outside air through this outside surface, the resistance due to conduction through this thickness of wall, and then resistance due to convection from this inner surface of glass to the inner surrounding of this room. Okay. Three resistances are in series one after another. So first of all, what will be the thermal resistance of convection happening from the outside air to this surface? Okay. Suppose I say that for this case, the associated convective heat transfer coefficient is H1, okay, and inside the associated convective heat transfer coefficient is H2, okay. So I am writing over here R convection, okay, outside will be equals to 1 upon H1 A. Suppose A is the surface area of glass, okay. And R conduction will be what? If K is the conductivity of the glass and T is the thickness, so we know this thing, thermal resistance due to conduction is given by L by K. So over here L is what? The thickness of the glass, T by K into A, and R convection inside is equals to 1 by H2 A. Okay. So all these resistances are in series one after another, from outside to inside. So in series case, what will happen? The overall thermal resistance will be what? R convection outside plus R conduction plus R convection inside. Okay. This is the overall thermal resistance. Okay. And heat transfer rate will be simple. It is equals to T2 minus T1 by the overall thermal resistance. Okay. So, hope by this small lecture you would have understood that what is thermal resistance network and how it follows the electrical resistance system analogy and how to solve the numericals of thermal resistance network. Thank you.